Hola, en esta lección vamos a hablar sobre los mandatos de ustedes. Before watching this video, you might watch the video series on to commands and the video series on usted commands. This video will be very similar to the rules we applied to the usted commands. So, imagine you want to order around multiple people. Of course, if you were in Spain, you would also need to know two forms. You need to know the vosotros for commanding people informally, and the ustedes form for ordering people around more formally. You can see the video on the vosotros commands by clicking on this video. But in Latin America, you just need the ustedes form for ordering around multiple people or multiple things. It's actually just like the usted commands, only with one additional letter at the end. Can you guess which letter would be at the end? R, S, T, L, N, or E. Just like every other ustedes form has, drumroll please, yes, the letter N. So we'll take the usted forms of the commands, and the ustedes forms will be the same in the affirmative and negative versions, but we'll add an N on the end of it. So to form them, take the present tense forms of the verbs in the yo form, then take off the O. And for AR verbs, we'll add an EN to the end. Let's look at some examples. Hablar, llamar, pensar, and esperar. In the yo forms, we have hablo, llamo, pienso, and espero, and then take off the O and add EN. Hablen, llamen, piensen, esperen. And to make these negative, it's pretty simple, just put a no in front. No hablen, no llamen, no piensen, no esperen. Now if we wanted to do an ER verb, then we're going to take the verb in the yo form, take off the O, and add AN. Some examples, comer, leer, volver, and tener. So change them into the yo form, you have como, leo, vuelvo, and tengo. Take off the O and you'll add an AN, coman, lean, vuelvan, tengan. Again, notice the spelling changes because vuelvan has that stem changed, O-D-U-E, and tengan has that extra letter G in there, and those are going to appear in the command as well. And to make these negative, just put a no in front. No coman, no lean, no vuelvan, no tengan. And we'll do some IR verbs. IRs are just going to be the same thing. Take the verb in the yo form, take off the O and add AN. Some examples, escribir, vivir, dormir, and decir. Let's change those to the yo forms. Escribo, vivo, duermo, and digo. And take off the O and add AN. Escriban, vivan, duerman, and digan. Again, notice spelling changes for dormir changes to duermo, and decir changes to digo, and so we're going to keep that spelling change in the ustedes command. To make these negative, just put a no in front. That simple. No escriban, no vivan, no duerman, no digan. Now, there are a couple things that I want to point out to you. Notice that if they are AR verbs that end in CAR, GAR, and ZAR, they will have a spelling change. So C-A-R will change to Q-U-E-N to preserve the K sound. G-A-R verbs will end in G-U-E-N to preserve that G sound. And Z-A-R verbs will end in C-E-N just because. Some examples, saquen, busquen, and toquen for some C-A-Rs. And some G-A-Rs, lleguen, paguen, peguen. And some Z-A-Rs, abracen, crucen, gocen. And we'll have some irregulars as well. Is the same as before. We have dar, estar, ir, saber, and ser because they follow no pattern whatsoever. They're just what they are. When it comes to pronouns like direct or indirect or reflexive, it's the same as we did with the to commands and the usted commands. If it's an affirmative command that is a non-negative command, then we'll just attach to the end the indirect object, the direct object, or the reflexive. So here are some examples. Díganles, tell them, duérmanse, fall asleep. Levántense, get up, váyanse, go away, and cómansela, eat it. Notice that we're going to add an accent mark to the second to last syllable before we add these on to keep and preserve that sound. If they're negative, we're going to put these pronouns before, like we would normally after the no. No les digan, don't tell them. No se duerman, don't fall asleep. No se levanten, don't get up. No se vayan, don't go away. No se la coman, don't eat it. Muy bien, that's all for this explanation of ustedes commands. Let me know if you have any questions or comments about this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for updates on new Spanish video lessons. And you might check out some of the other videos in this series on forming commands in Spanish. If you'd like to practice these ustedes commands, click on this video, or click on any of these videos to see how to form the other commands. Gracias por mirar y nos vemos.